Making this video for those that have children that have imaginary friends. Children that have imaginary friends. It's time for you to intervene. It's not time for you to take them to no psychiatrist. If you are a Christian, you ought to intervene and ask who that imaginary friend is. Talk to your children and ask your child who is this imaginary friend is. And when you ask your child who the imaginary friend is, you ought to go to God, go to God in prayer so God can reveal to you who this person is. Take it seriously, my friend. Don't play with demons. Don't play with a spirit of a cult. Don't play with a spirit of voodoo. Don't play with a spirit of witchcraft. The imaginary friends, you gotta know who this person is talking to, who this child is playing with. Hey, glory to God. A psychiatrist, hey, glory to God, won't help your child. But I know one person can, the power of the Holy Ghost. But first, you got to introduce yourself, glory to God, to this imaginary child. Hey, glory to God, imaginary creature that intervene in your child life. My friend, take this thing very seriously. How you doing? Take it very seriously that this person is talking to a person of real reality existence. This person is taking it to another level. My friend, I believe in devils. I believe in demons. I believe that the occult world exists. And even though this is the eve or this Halloween, imaginary friends are demons. Imaginary friends are real. My friend, your child or adult is not dealing with a make-believe. They're dealing with the spirit of Luciferian. Glory to God. I don't take, glory to God, hallelujah, imaginary friends as a joke. I take it with serious issue, because mental state is not a mental state can be healed with medicine. But I know one person that can heal their mental state. That's the power of the Holy Ghost, the power of Jesus. Let's go to the Bible, because the Bible is my reference. The Bible is my research to deal with your mental state, mental issue, mental situation. The man, glory to God, had cut himself with stone in a cemetery. Yes, the cemetery, the place where dead folks are buried, the place where tombstones are. And the Bible say they put this man in a cemetery because he cut himself and no chain bound him. So they carry this man and put him in a cemetery. And while he's at the cemetery, he cries out. He was at the cemetery day and night, cutting himself with stone. And the Bible say Jesus saw the man. And when Jesus saw the man, the man with the condition ran to Jesus. And Jesus say, "What is your name?" And the man say, "My name is Legion, because we are many." Hey, glory to God. And the Bible say that the demons was talking to Jesus, and the demons say, "Don't cast us into the abyss," which don't cast into the country, but cast us into the swine. And Jesus said, "Go," and the demons choked themselves into the river. Hey, glory to God. Hallelujah. But first they got into the swine, and the swine, hallelujah, got into the river, and the swine was drowned, but the demons was not destroyed. Hey, glory to God. And the Bible say, "What is your name?" And they say, "Our name are Legion, because we are many." So legion mean a thousand. Legion mean a multitude of demons that take charge over this man mine. Hey, glory to God. And the Bible say when the demon left the man, the Bible say he was clothed and he was in his right mind. And they went back and want Jesus to leave their city. They say, Jesus, leave our city, Jesus, because you are crazy. Jesus wasn't crazy. The man was at the cemetery was crazy. And Jesus delivered him. What I'm saying to you, my friend, if your child have an imaginary friend, it's time for you to intervene and talk to your child about who the imaginary friend you are talking to. Who, hallelujah, is the imaginary friend? Mommy or daddy like to meet your imaginary friend. What the imaginary friend name? His name might be Charlie. His name might be Jill. His name might be Sabrina. His name might be Samantha. His name might be Johnny. Go lucky. But I want to know the name of your imaginary friend. And once you know the name of the imaginary friend, I want you to talk to God so God can help you how to help your child to be delivered from the imaginary child, from the imaginary person in your child life. My friend, this thing is serious. This thing is no laughing matter. This thing that taken to a therapy of a mental state, this thing gotta be taken up in prayer. This thing gotta take up in spiritual warfare. This thing gotta take up, glory to God. The Bible say the weapon of warfare are not carnal, but a mighty through God pulling down of stronghold. So does your child have an imaginary child? What to do? Ask your child who your imaginary child is, imaginary friend is. And once you know the name, go to God and ask God, what shall I do? My friend, this thing is serious. Because what gonna happen if you allow this imaginary child, this imaginary person to take over your child mind, your child gonna end up in St. Elizabeth. Your child gonna end up into a mental institution. And like the man that was at the cemetery, hey, glory to God. The Bible say, hey, glory to God. Jesus told the demon to leave. And when Jesus Christ told the demon to leave, the demon obeyed Jesus, and the Bible say he was clothed and in his right mind. The Bible say, let this mind be in you as was in Christ Jesus. So Jesus can give your child that right mind. Hallelujah. And people that's on drugs, hey, people that drinking wine and getting drunk, people that involved in sexual promiscuity. Every time you have sex with a different person, you are attracting the spirit that's in that person. Hey, glory to God, you become a whoredom. And when a whoredom, you are collecting all the spirit of idolatry. So I'm saying to you, my friend, take this imaginary friend very seriously in your child or in your adult, because I believe that God can heal, glory to God, mental retardation. I believe that God can help those that are, hallelujah, bipolar. I believe God can help those that are schizophrenic, hallelujah, seeing things. I believe the power of God can heal the mind. He's a mind regulator. He's a heart fixer. Hallelujah, glory to God. And I just believe God. Do you believe God? You believe God can? God is able to do exceedingly above all we ask or think according to the power that work in us? I believe God for you. So Father God, bless this person. Bless this mother right now that's dealing with a child Hey, glory to God, that have issue off, glory to God, imaginary friends, bless right now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, oh God, bless his mother to know that God is able. God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all we ask or think, according to power, according to dunamis, hallelujah, that work in us. Bless right now. Bless his mother. Bless his father. Oh God, let them know that God come, that they may have life and have it more abundantly. Bless right now. Bless even that child that's in this situation, oh God, of neglect. Hallelujah. This child been in a situation where the mother been drinking wine. The mother been soaking cocaine. The mother been on crack. The mother, oh God, been in prostitution. Oh God, bless this mother. Hallelujah. Bless this father. Bless this child right now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Subscribe to my video and may God bless, bring healing to your child.